Groucho Marx is here, ready for his role as Waldorf T. Flywheel. Black mustache, horn rim, spectacles and all. There's Chico too, looking just the way he does in pictures. Ready to portray Emmanuel Ravella, Italian accent and all. The curtain is rising. On the offices of Flywheel, Shyster, and Flywheel. That's Miss Dimple at the switchboard.
Miss Dimple, put down that telephone book. This office is no place for a bookworm.
Yes, Mr. Flywheel.
Any mail this morning?
Yes, there's a letter from the typewriter company. They say you haven't paid for the typewriter yet.
Why should I pay for the typewriter? You're the
only
one who uses it. But Mr. Flywheel, I... Never mind. Take a letter to those cheap chiselers. Gentlemen, I never ordered that typewriter. If I did, you didn't send it. If you sent it, I never got it. If I got it, I never paid. And I don't intend to. Best regards.
Anything else, Mr. Flywheel?
Yes, love and kisses, but don't send them. That's for you. And now, take a letter to the Peerless Building Supply Company. Gentlemen, I refuse to accept a penny less than $50 for the electrical fixtures in this office. In case I do not hear from you, I shall conclude that you do not wish to pay me the $12, so in order to lose no time, I shall accept the
$12. But Mr. Flywheel, you can't
sell those fixtures. They belong to the landlord. Well, they ought to be glad. I'm selling them all and they can pay his rent. Say, tell that assistant of mine to wrap up the chandelier. Well, when he comes in, you better tell him to take out more fire insurance, because I intend to fire him.
Well, here he comes. Hello, Mr. Ravelli.
Hello, Miss Dip. Hello, boss.
Ravelli, do you realize you're a half an hour late?
I couldn't help it, Mr. Flywheel. I fell down a whole flight of stairs.
Well, did it take you a half an hour to fall down one flight of stairs? Anyway, I don't believe that story.
All right, if you don't believe that story, I'll tell you another one. I can't believe it because we had a little money trouble at our house. Yeah, my little brother, he swallowed a nickel.
Really? What did you do?
Well, next week's his birthday anyway, so I let him keep the nickel.
You stop jabbering and clean up my desk.
I cleaned out the desk yesterday. That's where I got the nickel.
Rebecca, I'm going into my private office. When I come back, I don't want to catch you loafing.
All right, if you don't want to catch me loafing, you better whistle before you come out.
A busy little office with bright, smiling faces.
Oh, shut up.
Excuse me. You see, I represent the Excelsior House-to-House Merchandise Company.
Well, there's nobody here by that name. This is Flywheel's office.
You don't understand. If you give me just a moment of your time, I'd like to show you a few choice values in neckties, safety razors, hair tonic. Say, let me tell you about this tonic. It's the real thing.
All right, give me a taste.
No. Now, before I began using this tonic, my hair was getting pretty thin.
Well, it don't look so fat now.
You just try it once. We guarantee every bottle.
Oh, the bottle, she looks all right, but I think the stuff inside is no good. Hey, how much for that necktie?
Now you're talking. I'm going to sell you that tie for $1.
A dollar?
Yes, brother, and it's a steal at that price.
Hey, if I'm gonna steal it, I can get it for nothing.
$1 and the tie is yours. Why, I paid 95 cents for it myself.
Well, if you paid only 95 cents, why should I pay $1?
Well, the nickel's my profit. You know, I've got a wife to support.
You think I'm gonna help support your wife? Nobody supports my wife, not even me. I'll tell you what, you leave the necktie and I'll send you 95 cents care of Woodlawn Cemetery.
Woodlawn Cemetery? That's not my address.
Well, it will be by the time I send you the 95 cents. Some joke, eh?
I can see I'm just wasting my time here.
Well, it took you a long time to find it out.
Goodbye.
Did I hear someone come in?
Yes, a wise guy. He wanted a nickel for his wife.
A nickel for his wife? Well, that sounds cheap enough. Was she good looking?
All right, come in.
Mr. Flywheel, permit me to introduce myself. I'm Bertram T. Barwell. I suppose you've been hearing about my charity work and my fight against crime?
Oh, yes. I've been hearing about that for a number of years, and I'm getting pretty sick of it.
Why, I happened to be in court this morning when I heard your thrilling address to the jury sent that man to prison for 5 years where he belongs.
My speech sent him to prison? Yeah, that's a good one on the jury. I was defending the guy.
Just a moment, Mr. Flywheel. Let me ask you a question.
Hey, I got a question too, boss. What animal likes dirt, always plays in the mud, and eats anything?
I know, Valley. It's you.
Mr. Flywheel, my organization is waging an intensive fight against crime in this city, and I feel that you're a man who can help us drive the crooks out of town.
Hey, why should we drive them out? Let them walk.
Nice work, Valley.
You see, gentlemen, my committee is determined to rid the city of public enemy number one, Big Joe Crookley. Although Crookley himself is in hiding, he has crime organized like a big business. In fact, some of his gangsters have an office only 2 doors from here.
I'd rather get to the right man. There isn't enough room in this town for gangsters and me, Waldorf T. Flyfly. Why, that's why we're putting up a big hotel in the spring.
Boss, you leave it to me. Ravelli's a plenty smart. I go next door and tell them gangsters to move.
An excellent idea, Ravelli, but wait a minute. You've got your hat on wrong.
Well, I don't know which way I'm going yet. And say, if you see my brother, tell him to wait.
I don't know your brother.
I never thought of that. All right, don't tell him. Tell him not to wait. Goodbye.
Mr. Flywheel, I can see you're a man of action. Sometime later, I'd like to interest you in our charity work.
Charity work? Well, I'm not the kind of fellow who likes to talk about his good deeds, but it may interest you to know that I've been sending pretty large-sized checks to various charities, and not even the charities know where the money's coming from.
But, Mr. Flywheel, I don't understand. Couldn't they tell by the name on the checks?
No. That's how modest I am. I don't even sign the checks.
Why, Mr. Flywheel, what's this? Someone put a note under the door.
Well, pick up the door and give it.
It says, my good heavens, it's from Crookley's gangsters. They've kidnapped Mr. Ravelli for meddling in their affairs.
Kidnapped him?
Listen to this. Unless you send us $10,000, we will kill Emmanuel Ravelli.
They'll kill him? Mr. Flywheel, what are you going to do?
All right, keep cool, Barbara. Miss Dimple, take a letter to Big Joe Crookley. Dear Joe, received yours of the fifth installment, in which you state that unless you send $10,000, you'll kill Ravelli. I haven't got the money, but the proposition sounds very attractive. Send further advice.
Who's there?
Open that door, Slim. It's me, Crookley.
Okay, Chief. I was scared it was the cops.
You don't have to be scared. The cops won't ever find this place. Where's that fella Ravelli?
Inside Eden. That's all he's been doing since we grabbed him off a week ago. Hey, Chief, is that lawyer Flywheel coming through with the 10 grand?
I think so. He's on his way over here now.
Say, what if he brings the cops?
Don't worry. He won't go shooting off his mouth. I told Flywheel what's good for him. Now I think I'll have a little talk with Ravelli.
Right, Chief.
Hey, Ravelli. Ravelli, put that dish down. I'm talking to you.
Oh, hello, Mr. Crookley. Sit down. Have a piece of pie. I just had 3 pieces. I'm afraid to eat anymore.
What?
Sure, if I eat too much pie, I'm afraid I get pie-a-ria.
Look here, Mark. We've been treating you pretty nice. You know why? Because if Flywheel don't show up with that 10,000 bucks today, you ain't gonna live very long.
Hey, you crazy? I feel fine. I think I eat some more pie.
Who is it?
Say, Chief, there's a guy coming in. I think it's that Flywheel.
Flywheel? Don't let him in till I hide the pie.
Bring him up here.
Okay, Chief. This way, mister.
Well, Flywheel, I...
Cut out the formalities. When are you going to kill Ravelli?
Hey, boss, is that what they want to do?
Don't be alarmed, Ravelli. I fixed everything. I've written a farewell note to your wife. I've sent flowers to your sweetheart. And I've also arranged a nice, quiet little funeral. There'll be 8 carriages for your family and a motorcycle for your friend.
When stolen Flywheel, did you raise that money?
Well, I raised the money all right, but unfortunately I spent it all on Ravelli's funeral.
Come on in.
Hey, Chief, I gotta talk to you.
All right, I'll be right with you. Listen, Flywheel, you and Ravelli stay right here. Come on here, Slim, what is it?
Chief, Butch just called and said we better lay low on these guys. The cops is all steamed up about the kidnapping, and they kind of suspect you.
Okay, I'll try to grab off the dub and throw them both out.
Yeah. Maybe you'd better, Chief.
Look here, Flywheel, forget the 10 grand. You give me $5,000 and Rebelli here can leave.
Sure, I'd like to leave here. It's a very nice house to leave in.
Well, what about that 5,000?
5,000? Quickly, can you make it 3,000?
All right, I'll make it 3,000.
That's talking quickly. Now, if you make it 2,000, I'll make it 1,000. And I haven't got the cash in my money, though, but I'll give you a note for 30 days, and if it isn't paid, you can keep my note.
Listen, you guys, I'm going to give you exactly 5 minutes to make up your minds. When I come back, you're either going to fork over the dough, or it'll be curtains for the both of you. Got me? Curtains for you both. Now, think fast.
Boss, we're in a tight fix. What are we going to do?
Well, first, Rebelli, I think I'll have a piece of that pie. Take some for yourself.
Thanks, boss, I'm full.
Well, I'll put some in your pocket.
They fall too. It's Crookley.
Crookley? He's probably bringing up the curtains.
Better hurry up, you guys. You got just 2 more minutes.
Rebelli, I've got to give this a lot of thought.
Hey, boss, I've got an idea.
Be quiet, I can't hear myself talk.
That's all right, you ain't missing anything. Say, it's cold in this room.
Well, it is kind of chilly, see what the thermometer says.
Oh, you can't believe that thermometer. One day it's 60, next day it's 65, it's a no-good.
Well, the thermometer ought to be kept at 70.
I can fix that easy, I just light a match under it, watch.
Remember, be careful of those drapers.
Hey, boss, the drapes are burning. Oh, Lord, look at that fire.
Oh, Brooklyn,
what do you want?
Can I use your telephone?
You think I'm crazy?
Answer my question first. Can I use your telephone?
And let you call the cops, I suppose?
No, not at all. I just wanted to call the fire department and ask where the nearest alarm box is. Brooklyn, I don't want to seem like an old gossip, but your house is on fire.
What? What's that? What you guys been up to? Slim!
What's up? What's wrong?
Quick, bring some water.
You can make mine ginger ale.
And I'll take some pie. Hey, I know a song about pie. Good pie forever.
Say, quickly, why don't you call the fire department? I know all the boys cooking lot of 78. And tell them to bring over a deck of peanut butter pies.
Nothing doing. I don't want no cops or firemen snooping around here.
He's right, boss. There's no use calling in the fire department now. The place is already on fire.
Rebelli, open the windows. Open the windows, I said. This smoke is beginning to get to me.
Yeah, there's too much smoke. You better put on your cigar.
Boys, the fire is spinning fast. Better start running.
Hey, Flywheel, I know a good place to run to.
Where, Rebelli? Where?
To run to Canada. Ha! Hot stuff, eh, boy?
Gentlemen, the court wants this case to
proceed.
Very well, Your Honor. If you and Ravelli will let me keep your trap shut, I'll proceed. As I was about to say, before the judge wanted in, when I was a wee bit of a tot, I left, was left as an orphan.
You was left an orphan? What did you do with it?
State's Attorney Office has been requested by the Citizens Committee that to let Mr. Flywheel conduct the prosecution because of his splendid work in tracking down Joe Crookley.
Very good. Joseph Crookley, where's your attorney?
Judge, I offered to pay plenty, but I couldn't get a lawyer in this town with nerve enough to take my case. I even offered to pay as high as $5,000.
Just a minute, Your Honor. I'm talking now not as Flywheel, a lawyer, but as Flywheel, a man, the defender of human rights. In a court of justice, Your Honor, every man has a certain inalienable rights, and every man has a right to advice and counsel of a lawyer, especially if he has $5,000. Quickly, I'll take your case. Try out the $5,000.
Mr. Flywheel, the court was under the impression that you were going to prosecute Crookley.
Well, I was under that impression too until I heard about the $5,000. Let's start the case. The first witness for the defense is Emmanuel Ravelli.
Mr. Flywheel, you can't call Ravelli for the defense. He's the man who says he was kidnapped.
Oh, so that's his story. Well, that didn't even spread. How about he's a liar?
Hey, what do you mean calling me a liar?
You're a liar. I didn't call you a liar. Your Honor, he wouldn't tell the truth under oath, and Ravelli, get up there and take the oath.
Okay, boss.
Up to you.
Order, order, order. Emmanuel Ravelli, you promise to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth.
Hey, you want me to lose my job?
Emmanuel Ravelli, where were you born?
I wasn't born. I had a stepmother.
Ravelli, tell the court your birthday.
What do you want to know for, Judge? You ain't going to buy me nothing.
He's right, Your Honor. You haven't bought a thing since you bought your seat on the bench.
See here, Mr. Flywheel, the court considers that remark most unnecessary and vicious.
Hey, Judge, that's what I got for my birthday.
You got what?
Vicious. I got a telegram with very best vicious. Ha! Some joke.
Please, can we get on with this hearing? Mr. Ravelli, will you kindly state your age?
Sure, Judge, I'm just 28.
28? Why, you said that you were 28 when you appeared here in this court 2 years ago.
Well, when Ravelli says something in court, he sticks to it.
There you are. I guess that'll hold you for a while. I make a motion that you dismiss the charges against my client.
Motion denied. Mr. Flywheel, have you another witness? I don't think this one is intelligent enough to understand court proceedings.
Did you hear that, Ravelli? Your Honor, just to show you what a fool you're making of yourself, I'm going to give my witness an intelligence test. Ravelli? What's the first letter of the alphabet?
Give me a hint.
Ravelli, is that question so hard for you to answer?
No, the question's easy. The answer's hard.
All right, I'll try another one. Where was the Declaration of Independence signed?
At the bottom.
There you go.
The court cannot help but regard all of this as irrelevant and immaterial. Mr. Flywheel, you now claim that Crookley did not kidnap Ravelli. How is it that Crookley was found at the scene of the crime, where he was holding Ravelli prisoner?
Well, frankly, Judge, that's a goddamn kind of puzzle, too. Say, maybe it wasn't Ravelli who kidnapped Crookley. Your Honor.
Silence in the court.
Your Honor, in a case of as important as this, we cannot be swayed by our emotions. Nothing matters but hard, cold facts. Remember, I too have a baby. We met her in a dance hall. And Your Honor, I couldn't go home and face my baby if I felt I wasn't vending a guilty man.
Just a moment, Mr. Flywheel. The prosecution hasn't heard from yet. Do you expect to talk much longer?
Certainly. The longer I talk, the longer my client stays out of jail. Your Honor, Joe Crookley is really a fine boy at heart. He's very good to his family. He never goes home. Why, for a whole year, he didn't talk to his wife. Why? Why didn't he talk to his wife? Because he didn't want to interrupt her. Now, Your Honor, I demand that you
respond. I hate you, corporate.
You don't need to be your barrister, Judge. I don't know what it means either.
Mr. Flywheel, you've wasted enough of this court's time. Mr. District Attorney, call your witness.
Your Honor, the state has been surprised in this case. We had counted on Emmanuel Ravelli as our witness, and since he shifted to the defense, I'm afraid we have no case.
In that event, I am forced, much against my will, to dismiss charges and release the defendant, Joseph Crook. quickly, you may go.
Thanks, Judge. So long there, Flywheel.
Judge, he's leaving the courtroom. Bring him back here.
Bring Crookley back?
He owes me $5,000.
Oh, you're crazy, boss. We owe him $5,000.
We owe him $5,000.
Sure. He had $10,000 in his wallet.
Well?
But I got his wallet.
We're going to take a short intermission now, but be back in your seats in 10 minutes for Act 2 of our holiday episode of Dragnet.